Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hey guys, what's going on? This is The List. This is a program that I did several years ago and haven't done since, but I'm bringing it back because I want to get more and more audience participation in the videos that I'm making. The List is, I create a poll, place it on my social media accounts, and you, the Dogumentary TV audience, you guys vote on the topic at hand. Now for the topic of this first poll, it was a top 10 protection animals. But before I jump into this video, please, if you haven't already, subscribe to the channel. Be sure to like, leave a comment if you have anything you want to say, a question, or an idea for another video. Let's start it off with number 10 on your list. This is not my list, this is your list. I will though, however, tell you how I feel about how you have these dogs ranked. At number 10, you guys have the South African Mastiff with 49 write-in votes. Not a dog breed that I personally like for personal protection or home protection in a, in an urban or suburban setting, but I do believe that they do well and are very functional. I just feel like these dogs have other needs that would be much better suited if they were able to exist in a rural environment. On number 9, you guys rank the Bouvier de Flanders. The Bouvier received 78 votes. What I do like about the Bouvier is a medium-sized dog, not a large breed. It does have agility and is very intelligent. This breed I would put into the category of some of your smaller protectors like the Belgian Malinois, Dutch Shepherd. Not quite as efficient as those breeds, but still a good protector and honestly much easier to live with than the other two breeds that I mentioned. At number 8, you guys have the Beauceron, which is one of my favorite dog breeds for home protection and personal protection. The Beauceron received 182 votes. Now, what I love most about the Beauceron is it is kind of like a Doberman Shepherd. Because if you look at them, that's what they look like, for one. But two, they also kind of operate like that in terms of speed and agility. The large male Beauceron can get up to roughly 100 pounds, which gives them a lot of stopping power. All right, guys, the number 7 breed on the list is the Dutch Shepherd, receiving 188 votes from the Dogumentary TV audience. Well, I have no problem with the Dutch Shepherd at this spot. I think Dutch Shepherds are one of the most elite military and police dogs in the world. I don't necessarily like them for myself for protection because, again, they're not a dog that's easy to live with. A lot of energy. These dogs require a lot of attention and they want to do a lot in a day. So you guys have them at number 7, which I think is about right. I might not have them on my list, but they are definitely dogs that do work and they are very smart and very efficient. The number 6 dog on the list, receiving 286 votes, is the Bull Mastiff. Now you guys are getting right into my wheelhouse. I love large dogs with stopping power, but also, very low energy, easy to live with. You know, if you have a family, a job, like after school activities, sporting activities, you have a full day already, you don't need a dog that requires 2 to 3 hours of activity to remain sane. I think the Bull Mastiff is great. It isn't necessarily the most effective protector. It probably lacks the speed for personal protection work, but as far as a home and estate guardian, probably can't do much better than the Bull Mastiff. At number 5, receiving 940 votes, you have the Doberman Pinscher. Excellent choice as a home and a personal protector. I love the Doberman Pinscher. I personally would have this breed maybe a bit higher. Looking at the list as it is right now, I'm not going to tell you what's in front of it, but there are at least one, maybe two breeds that I would put the Doberman Pinscher ahead of. So probably on my list, it would probably be around 3. But you guys have it at 5, so that's your list, and that's where it's going to stay at. At number 4, you guys have the Belgian Malinois. Again, very much like the Dutch Shepherd, this dog is an elite military and police dog. I personally don't necessarily like it for personal nor home protection. I mean, it's much better, I guess, at a personal protector. I just feel like the dog is a lot to live with, a lot, you know, you have to do a lot to keep the dog happy and sane. That's just me based on my lifestyle. You know, being a father, having kids, having a whole bunch of activities, having a full-time business I'm running. I don't need a dog that requires 2, 3, 4 hours of my time in a day. At number three, you guys placed the Rottweiler. You guys know this would be one or two on my list. You know how I get down, right? But I'm, number three, I'm not mad at it. Looking at the breeds that you guys have ahead of it. Okay, if that's how y'all feel, if that's how y'all feel, I'll accept the Rottweiler at number three. It received 1,222 votes. So that's not bad. At number two, the German Shepherd. Now, German Shepherd received 1,363 votes. I love this pick. I love it at number two. I don't know what I did on my last protection list, my last personal protection list, but I'm sure the German Shepherd was either two or three. So I think it's right there. I don't know if I said it, but the German Shepherd received 1,363 votes. And, you know, I'm not mad at all with that placement. I think this is a great dog, has a good balance of workability and livability. At number one, you guys have the Connie Corso at 1,482 votes, which, okay, that's how y'all feel. Again, that's how y'all feel. That's how y'all feel. We're going to live with it. It's your list. It's not my list. And I'm not mad at it. I think the Connie Corso is a great dog for living. It is definitely a good protector. I think it is an exceptional property, home and property protector, and a more than serviceable personal protector. So yeah, it's, you know, it's got a great balance. And I think for me, it would probably be, I couldn't put it ahead of the German Shepherd, the Rottweiler, or the Doberman Pinscher. That would just be my issue with the pick at number one. All right, guys, but there you go. There you have it. Your top 10 list of personal protection dogs. You guys did a good job. Like I said, it's not exactly what I would want, but it is what you guys voted for, and therefore it is what it is. All right, guys, if you guys have any ideas for another poll that I could create, and we could create another list of a topic for us to create a list around, please leave me a comment in the comment section, and I'll get to it. And we'll keep doing these moving forward. All right, guys, this is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV. Peace.